Hello, my name is Arun Nagarajan and I'm a developer advocate at Google. Today we'll talk about building iOS apps with Google APIs. Did you know that Google's one of the top application developers on the iOS App Store? We build dozens of applications for iPhone and the iPad that are used by tens of millions of users. We also provide a lot of APIs and services to iOS developers so that you too can build a lot of these amazing experiences for your users. We are big believers in reaching users wherever they are, and our tools go beyond Chrome and Android. In this session, we'll walk through several of these APIs and services that we provide for iOS developers, and we'll approach them in terms of the problem that you as a developer might try to solve, and then talk about the Google API that we think will help you immensely in that case. First, let's talk about building your application's backend data store and logic. Every great application needs a powerful backend infrastructure that confidently scales with the application needs. Your application's backend might perform some operations that are asynchronous, or store some photos, or do push notifications, and really a lot of the scenarios that you can imagine for an application that you may build. And the nice thing is that Google's got you covered with a great service that we call Google Cloud Endpoints. We can build services on App Engine and expose them as APIs for your iOS apps. And the nice thing is that these APIs are also accessible from Android and web apps, so you're covered in all fronts. Here you can see a server logic in Python, really straightforward with the client-side API call below it. And you can see how the server logic is annotated with the API semantics and the client-side API is generated fully on the API spec in the server side. So it feels very natural and conforming to the API that you've defined. Next up, you need to be able to register and sign in new users. And this is really important for a quality application because you want to personalize your application, store some settings, and be able to restore the user's state, and you need to know who they are at the keyboard. And Google Plus sign-in for iOS really lets you solve this very easily. Drop in the G Plus sign-in framework into Xcode and you're off to the races. The GPP sign-in instance will control the registration and the login flows. And once the user's signed in, you can actually use the API to request additional information like their profile, for instance, their picture, or other information about their social graph itself. You can even add in additional scopes like access to Google Drive or Calendar so that you can securely interact with those resources as well, and all that can be taken care of in one single sign-in and authorization flow. Adding Google Plus sign-in improves your app's registration and sign-in rates quite a bit. As an example, eDJing a DJ app for iOS saw an increase of the number of signed-in users on their iPhone by 32% and their iPad app by 42% after adding Google Plus sign-in. So that's quite a bit of increase there. And now that you have your users logged in, you want to be able to provide them with some pretty immersive experiences. And the good news is we've got you covered on that front as well. So let's talk about Google Maps first. Google Maps provides high-quality map imagery and information. You're familiar with that. And now you can easily embed Google Maps in your app as well. You can easily build a great map experience with your custom location data using the Google Maps SDK. Now here's a small snippet of code, and notice how we are using the GMS map view and providing it a marker and a camera instance. And there are some deeper APIs that go beyond this to add further interactivity or other additional advanced functionality. Google Cast enables multi-screen experiences that lets your users send and control from content from a small device like a phone or a tablet on a large screen device like a TV. So if your app displays video or other visual content that would look great on a big screen, we highly encourage you to take advantage of the Cast SDK. It's really straightforward to implement. The flow is first you try to scan for devices, and once you're registered against a device, you simply send the media content up to that device. The device is called the receiver, and you can actually customize the look and feel on the receiver using standard web technology in case of advanced scenarios. If you're a game developer, we got a great SDK for you. It's called Play Game Services. You can power up your games with achievements, leaderboards, real-time multiplayer, and cloud save capabilities. This SDK is cross-platform, so you cover it on all platforms. And the user could start their game on an iOS device and finish it on a web browser or compete against another user on an Android phone, for instance. Let's take a look at just one of these features of the Play Game Services called leaderboards. And leaderboards can be a fun way to drive competition amongst your players, even if they're just casual gamers. And here's a simple example of how you use the leaderboard using a GPG leaderboard controller, which provides a lot of simple APIs that you can launch and show the leaderboard without having to do much magic. There are probably many scenarios where you want to embed and show YouTube content in your application. Some of the content that you may have for help, for instance, or other instructional information are really well served by having that on YouTube. And the YouTube iOS Player Helper is an open source library that you can easily embed into your application and be able to show off this in a simple iframe. You can see that the YT Player View is a simple library, and you can see how easy it is to load and control a video from there. Let's now talk about how you can make your app get better with time. You'll of course want to know how your app is being used, what the popular sections and the not so popular sections are, and you want to be able to experiment and change things on the fly so that you're not always rebuilding and resubmitting your application. Luckily, we have two great tools for that. First, you're probably familiar with Google Analytics for websites, but did you know that there's also a Google Analytics SDK for your iOS native app? Here you can see how you can use that SDK. Really straightforward to track the analytics of a home screen in this example. And all that, of course, is securely tracked and logged in the Google Analytics web console. Another great tool for app developers is the Google Tag Manager. Google Tag Manager allows developers to change configuration values in their app without having to constantly rebuild and resubmit their apps. This is really useful for changing configuration values and settings in your application, like strings or various UI settings that you want to be able to have dynamic control over. And this sample snippet shows how the tag container is opened and how the value can be retrieved using a simple API call. Now it's time to talk about how you can generate money from your application. If your app sells physical goods, tickets, or services, you should really look into Google Wallet. Google Wallet Instant Buy enables you to access hundreds of millions of users that use Google Wallet and can pay via Google Wallet. And this also minimizes the data entry that they have to perform. So this is really good for everybody involved, including yourself as the developer. The two key parts in this sample code here are the masked wallet request that defines all the fields that you need in order to create an order. And the second part talks about how you, once the order is authorized, how you can get the proxy card to send the payment information to your processor. Another great way to monetize is by displaying high quality ads in your application, and you can easily do that with the AdMob SDK. Banner ads use a small portion of the screen to entice users to click through to a richer full screen experience. And notice in this snippet, we're creating a GAD banner view and adding that as a sub view within your application UI right there. So now to recap, we walked through 10 different APIs and services that Google offers for iOS developers. As you can see, these APIs help you solve a lot of the problems that you as a developer might have, regardless of the type of application you're building. We believe that you can build amazing experience with these APIs for your users on iOS. We've just barely scratched the surface with these APIs. Feel free to dig in and learn more at developers.google.com.